Y'all, I had to record because I started listening to Miley's album, and I gotta get my reaction on camera. Whoa. Ow! Oh my god! I've been sleeping on Miley's voice! I'm not going to be pausing it. I'm just going through and I'll edit it or something. I don't know what this is going to look like at the end, but I'm sorry. I just had to fucking... Flowers in hand. I know that you're wrong for me. Gonna wish we never met on the day I leave. Baby, angels like you can't fly down there with me. Oh. I'm everything they said I would be. Oh. Okay. Close your eyes. Know that you want orchestra bitch. God, I love that part. Oh. Did you hear the rasp on the U? Go back if you missed that. Yes. Oh, those claps or whatever. Bitch. Oh, this is the one with Dua Lipa. I didn't know we was going full future nostalgia here, but I'm ready now. Dude, these backup vocals in some of these songs are really good. So, like in the second track, Plastic Hearts, the title track, those backup vocals got me. That's why I started recording. Just let me go. That's nice. And the contrast with Dua's voice, like, because Dua's voice is kind of like smooth, and then Miley is like, ugh. Yeah. Ooh. I like that it's like empty. Yes.
It's the New Jersey Lottery scratch
okay.
Off edition caroler.
Okay, while this ad is going, holy. Sis, what? I've been sleeping on Miley Cyrus. Are you kidding me? I did not. I mean, I listened to like Younger Now. I listened to the single, like Malibu was great. Younger Now, I wish it did better. I like that song. I never listened to the full album, but like, I fucking should have because this hoe really giving us that power this time around. I don't know if this is what she sounded like in Younger Now, but like, I know in Banger, she was giving us power in Wrecking Ball. I should just listen to Miley's entire discography for real because I've been sleeping on this voice and I'm realizing that. Because I went back to listen, just like I was saying, how like Dua Lipa's voice is smooth and then Miley contrasts that. That song she did with Ariana Grande, they sounded so good together. Like, I need to catch up on Miley Cyrus, yo, because this is great so far. And I know that all, like, her music is different, like, through the eras, but, like, I'm sure, like, her voice is just. It transcends genre, like, period. Holy crap. All right, give me what I want. Yeah, you better. You've been doing it so far. Let's see what you got. Midnight and the moon is up tonight. You came here. Nice. 'Cause you know what I need. I'll give it to my mind. Oh! Love the lyrics. Oh, the layering. I hope this last chorus explodes a little bit. She said, I'm gonna do the opposite, sis. I'm gonna break it down for you. Damn. Okay, we're going right into the next track, Nightcrawling. Featuring who? Billy Idol. I don't even know who that is. I'm sorry. Nightcrawling, sky falling. Ooh, I like that melody. Going real 80s right here. I said I don't know who Billy Idol is, but I'm pretty sure I've heard the name. I don't, like, completely not know who he is. Yeah, this is giving me, like, just their combination of voices giving me Lady Gaga, Elton John vibes from that one song. One song from Lady Gaga's album. That's giving me those kind of vibes right now with their duet style here. Miley. Oh, they put auto-tune on her? I think I heard a little auto-tune on there, but still, she belts in right now. Ooh. Nightcrawling. Solid track right there. Midnight Sky, I've heard this once before, but I don't remember it. I remember, like, not really vibing it too hard the first time, but let's see if I vibe with it now. Yeah, I remember this chorus a little bit. Oh! I'm mad at you, Miley Cyrus, for giving us this rasp! Nice. Solid. That part was my favorite part of the song. I mean, I haven't heard the bridge yet, but that part's just so good. See, the thing about this track, there are certain parts that I really like, and it's not a skip at all, but it's just like, I wish the... Let me finish it before I say anything about this track. Oh!
So good!
Yeah, so I didn't really pay attention to the lyrics that much. I'm assuming it's talking about her previous relationships and whatever. See, there's parts of this track that I really like. Parts of it, the rest of it, I'm just, like, kind of vibing. It's not a skip, but it's not, like, great for me. This one called High? Okay. Got my mind going places it ain't wanna go. Oh, she's stripping it down. And you, like a neon light book. Oh. In my head, I did my very best saying goodbye. She gave us, like, country and folk vibes. Oh, this is getting hard already. You didn't have to do this! Damn! I love a nice little choir moment. The drums too are great. Damn, I wanted that one to keep going. I mean, like, I not, like, really, but, like, you know what I mean? It's just one of those songs that, like, you can vibe to for, like, 10 minutes and you'd still be going, you know? But, yeah, Midnight Sky, the actual song, I don't really vibe with it that hard yet. It could grow on me. I gotta listen to this album a few times, you know? I gotta feel it out. That last song, though, High... I love slow, like, kind of mellow songs like that. Like, a song that reminds me of that kind of a little bit is, like, Gone by Madonna. If you like High by Miley Cyrus, check out Gone. That's, like, kind of a, like, one of those songs you can just, like, kind of chill to. Or, like, yeah, I guess that's a good example. I don't know. I was going to list another, but I'm keeping it at that. Okay, next song is Hate Me. Okay, let's see what this is all about. Damn, she, like, switched from country to rock? Or rock to country? Okay, this is, like, genreless. I don't know what happened. Oh. Oh. She dated like Liam Hemsworth, right? Is that who all these songs is about? I like that lyric. I like the soul chorus, honestly. It's true, when you die, people's opinions change like that. No! She has Joan Jett on this album? The bald world, bitch! This was a good pair because their voices are similar, you know? In terms of like rasp and stuff. You know, she's saying she does what she wanna do and it's working, sis! She wanted to make a rock album instead of a pop album. And here we are, enjoying it, you know? She keeps faking me out with these, like, anti-drops, but I'm not mad at it. Nice. Okay, Never Be Mine. I don't wanna lean that way too far. I don't wanna ever learn the hard way. But if you're looking for... lyrics are obviously powerful. Did you hear that in the background? So is Miley just not built for love, man? Is that what she's saying? I mean, the last song she's saying she don't vibe with love. And now she's saying, I can never be that girl for you. Oh. She's admitting and aware that, and like it almost sounds like she's accepting of these things, but like the melody is also like kind of sad, so it's like a mixture of like two emotions to me. I don't know, that like was a little hard to listen to emotionally. Golden G string. The questions made more questions, staring out into the night. But I think I'll stay. That sawway face? There are layers to this body. Primal sex and trying to own my power. Yo! Still I'm trying to work it out. And at least it gives the paper something. I love the use of basic synths right now. And like squares and saws. I'm gonna have to re-listen to this for the lyrics because it sounds like she was talking about something serious. Oh, it's not even close to over. I thought we were like... Yeah, I'm gonna have to re-listen to this. But I'm gonna heart it for now anyway because I love the vibe. And I can tell she was talking about something like deep. You know, I just like wasn't really paying attention to that first listen, but I'll go back. Yo, this album is really good. I think that's the end. Wait, no, we still got, okay. There's two live performances, that this next song is like the last song, I think, technically. It's called Edge of Midnight. Midnight's, oh wait, no, this is a remix. So I think that's technically the end of the album. I'm not even sure, but I'm going to give my, I'm just going to say right now, like, wow. So that's technically like the outro. Like, that makes so much sense now, because it had a long like outro, chill vibe, like deep meanings. Yo, I'm so happy with this album. We've gotten a lot of good music this year. I mean, like, we got some Katy Perry. We got some Dua Lipa. I haven't listened to Taylor Swift's album. I don't really... I'm assuming it's good, though, because, like, from what I know, she went back to her country roots. Who else did we get this year? Lady Gaga. We got Lady Gags. Damn, we got a lot of music this year. I'm happy about it. We got some Billie Eilish, too. Not an album. Okay, here we go. Midnight Sky Remix. Okay. Sounds like it might just be an extended mix, maybe? Doesn't sound that much different than the original, but... Yeah, so I forgot to say, this has a feature on it. I didn't realize it was going to be a woman. It said Stevie, and I'm like, okay. I like this version better, y'all. This doesn't sound that different from the original. Yeah, that... I don't really like that they changed that part, because that was my favorite part of the song, but... Oh, damn. So, I mean, that was probably in the original, but, like... I forgot. The feature sounds so good. Oh. Why did they do that? That part was so good to hear. They could have just kept the same lyrics there. Like the ooh, da da da. That's shit. They should have kept that in this version. Anyway, I do like that version. It felt like the beginning might have been more stripped down from the other version. I don't know. Now, we got Heart of Glass, the live iHeartRadio shit. If you don't like this performance, you don't got ears. You know what I'm saying? Or eyes, because she looked good, too. I like this version more than the Blondie version. I gotta say it. Because Miley killed this. I mean, I already heard this one, so like, it's gonna be a bland reaction, but I'm gonna listen to it anyway on camera because it's hot. So it turned out I had a heart of glass. Her voice is just killer. Like, bruh. I've really been sleeping on Miley's voice. I'm so sorry, Miley Cyrus. It still gets me every time. We already knew we loved that one. I'm gonna put a heart to it. Cause we knew. We've been new. Wait, no way. Did she cover... She covered Zombie by the Cranberries? I mean, I don't really like this song, I'm not gonna lie, but let's see. Miley might turn around, cause I didn't like Heart to Glass that much until she performed it, so let's see. See, the main thing I don't like about the original version is all like the voice... It's like the voice cracking they do, so... The fact that she cut that out, thank you, because that shit was annoying. Also, I don't think I ever realized what this song was about before, but I'm getting it now. So, I appreciate the lyrical content. See, this is the part I don't like in the song either. This especially in the original, because they just do that like voice crack shit, and it's so annoying. Okay, guitarist, I see.
Yeah, I see you, drummer.
See, this part of the song sucks, am I wrong?
At least she kept it short. That part that I don't like.
She gives a growl and a rasp at the same time? Nice little cutoff ending there. Alright, y'all, so that's the album. I'm sorry y'all didn't... I don't know how much of the second song I got in. I don't know where I started. But I know I missed the whole first song. Overall, fucking great album. Like, I liked every song. Like, if I didn't love every song, I at least liked every song. You know what I'm saying? And that's how you know you made a good album. Like, because there'd be albums that I only like four songs off of them. So this is amazing. I just love her voice. I love that she's now doing like a rock style. I mean, some of those songs still had like a country vibe, like old, like Miley Cyrus kind of vibe. But yeah, my favorite, I don't know which one my favorite would be. I really like Plastic Hearts, actually. Like those background, that's the reason why I started, because I started hearing them background vocals. I can't remember which ones I like most. I don't know. I liked Prisoner with Dua Lipa. I did like that one. I remember that. I liked High, I think, right? Did I like High? That was the super chill one that I like related to like Madonna or whatever the hell I said. I don't even know. But yeah, those are like some of the ones I remember the most. Were like the Dua Lipa one, the title track, Plastic Hearts, High. I liked Hate Me. I thought the chorus was a little funny when that she was like, I hope when I die, my friends get drunk and high or whatever she said. That was nice. Anyway, great album. What the hell? Miley Cyrus, you're doing the damn thing. Like she said in one of the songs, she was like, I'm gonna do what I want. I don't give a fuck about what anybody else says. And that's on period. You do what you want, girl, because it's working. I remember back when fucking Wrecking Ball and shit was coming out, people were like, what the hell is she doing? And I was like, you know, she being crazy, but it's working. Y'all are watching. She's getting that money. She making great ass music. Wrecking Ball is a great song. Like, in the moment when it came out, I didn't appreciate it as much as I should have. That is a great song. And y'all can't even lie. Even if the video is a little whack. I mean, even the video was like kind of... It's kind of aged well over time now, because it's just like, wow, she really did that, you know? I don't know. I appreciate that era of Miley a lot more now than I did when it was happening. Anyway, thank y'all for watching. Hopefully I don't get, like, killed for putting music on this video, but anyway, Miley, great fucking job with this album. I'll see y'all soon if I make more videos. I don't know what the fuck I'm doing with this channel. I don't even know which channel I'm probably gonna post this on my main channel. Anyway, love y'all.